Our Father, we are thankful for a beautiful morning. Beautiful for so many reasons, but beautiful most of all because it reminds us of the resurrection of your Son. That is that event in history that we celebrate more than anything else. For that's what makes your Son different than anyone else. And Father, as we do that, we are drawn back to the reason for his resurrection, his crucifixion. And as we do that, we're reminded of the reason for his crucifixion, our sins. And when we think of that, we remember our Savior again. Thank you for him giving himself for us. Thank you, Lord, for your gift. And Father, as we commune today, we pray you bless us. And Father, we each have people in our lives that are hurting. Hurting because of loss, because of disillusionment, because of depression, because of health matters, because people that they love are hurting. And Father, as I pray for Benjamin, we each pray for those in our life that we're aware of who are hurting. We bring our prayers to the one who can do something about them. And Father, we then ask in that prayer that your will be done. That's the best thing we know to pray. And then we ask that we help, that we trust you to do your will. We love you. Bless us as we praise you in song and in all we do in this service today. We want to do right. Help us to do so. And bless this time. In Jesus' name, amen. Listen.
Let's go ahead and stand up for these first few songs. I've heard a lot of people say this weekend that it gets a little chilly in this room, so I figure the best way to do that is stand up and sing out. Everybody ready? I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. My voice is already starting to fail, which is great. So I'm going to start the sopranos and fade back. So again, if you know this song really well, we love it. I know we do. So let's sing out.
My soul magnifies the Lord.
You have given us. Father, we thank you for this wonderful time that we have had to already sing praises to your name. And I pray that as we continue in this worship service, we block everything out. We make sure that we are solely focused on worshiping you and learning more about what you have done for us and what you give to us, what you provide for us each day. Father, I pray that we put our whole self into this worship service. For that's what we're here to do on this day, on this weekend. I pray that you would see us all safely where we go today. We thank you for this weather, for we know that it will provide for things that need it for sure. But we just pray that you would keep us all safe in it as we are making our ways around town today. Father, we thank you for your Son who came to die on the cross for our sins, and it's in his name that we pray. Amen. You guys go ahead and be seated.
Christ alone, you took on flesh. Oh. Day by day,
to be here at worship this morning. Amen. Excellent. We've got two more songs before Paul comes to speak to us. So let's go ahead and stand and let's sing these out with everything that we have.
Come now, fount of every blessing, to my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, all our songs of
Thank you. Now is that opportunity, and maybe there's some here who have not yet put Christ on in baptism. Now is that time to find that situation of completeness and begin your complete forever. Because it all comes down to one thing: keeping your eye on the crown. Whatever we can do to help you, this is the Lord's invitation, and we ask you to answer it right now as together we stand and sing.
Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Crucified, laid behind the stone.
As we begin in worship together.
Over all the earth you reign on high, every mountain stream, every sunset sky, but my one request, Lord, my only aim, is that you reign in me again. Lord, reign in me, reign in your power over all my dreams, in my darkest hour. So won't you reign in me again, over every thought, over
to reign in me again. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I cannot trust the sweetest ring, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. When darkness veils his loving face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. When he shall come with trumpet sound, oh, may I live in him be found. Dressed in his righteousness alone, all blessed who stand before the throne. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. Lord, I lift your name on high.
And thou, O Lord, universe he rained down from high above.
Worship. We pray that, Father, our steps will bring you praise. Father, there are so many things. And our prayer tonight is that we will live for you. And Father, sometimes it is just a daily step. It's not looking for the future. It's not looking for what's going to happen 6 months from now or 6 years from now. But Father, for some of us here, it is just taking a step today and taking that next step tomorrow. And Father, we pray that you will be with us, that you will give us that strength, that we will be the people that you want to be, that when we leave here, Father, we pray that we are complete. And Father, we know that when things come into our lives that affect us, it breaks that bond, it breaks that circle. And Father, we're so grateful for speakers that we've had this weekend, for Brother Dan, who's going to come up here in a little bit and speak to us tonight. That Father, we pray that when we leave here, we are complete, that there isn't anything lacking. And Father, we pray that if there are people in here tonight, that there are holes, that there are things that are missing, that there is something that's just not right. Father, we pray that you will be with them, that you will touch them. And it's not about coming forward. It's not about coming up in front of a crowd. But Father, even within themselves, right there in their seat, Father, we pray that their lives will be focused and turned back upon you. Because Father, we don't want to miss the glory that waits. Heaven that waits. And Father, we pray that you will be with all of us. We pray that you will watch over us. And it's in your Son's name we pray. Amen. I'm going to grab something here real quick that Heath is bringing to me. Getting older stinks, in case you didn't know that. And about 4 months ago, I was diagnosed with something I thought I would never probably, or it would at least affect me, where I probably would struggle leading singing ever again. Because I had my Pitch Perfect moment. If you've seen the movie Pitch Perfect, the doctor came in and said, "Well, you have nodes." And so for the last 4 months, I have not led singing, I have not preached, I have not been able to do anything that I love to do. And so, when was it? When did we start exposure? Friday? So many days run together when you're here. That was actually the first time I've led singing in 4 months. Still got a long way to go. And so I just want to say there is something that I found out that we miss in our congregational singing. There is something when Paul says that we speak to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs that I guess you take for granted until you can't do it. And there's something about, like when Dale was coming up here and he was talking about, it's not about the song leader. It's all about us joining together in our voices, and we're speaking to each other and we're talking to each other and we're building each other up and we're singing praises to God. It's not about the person up here. It's about all of us in communion together, worshiping him. And that's what makes places like Exposure and things like that, and even at your home congregation, that if I can encourage you is don't take this moment for granted. Don't take these things for granted. Don't look at singing as, well, we're just getting to the preaching because that's really why we're here. It's all built in together. Because our worship and our singing that we're giving reflects how we feel about God, reflects how we feel about the church, reflects how we feel about each other. And so if I can encourage you to think about that as we sing the rest of these songs tonight, as we'll go to the atrium singing, I know everybody's looking forward to. It's not about the sound. It's beautiful, but it's not about the sound. It's about what comes from right here. And so if I can encourage you, take everything else away. Take everything else in your life. And I know it's hard sometimes to set it aside, but set it aside for these next few moments as we sing these songs and open up your heart to God. You call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will. My soul will rest in your hands.
Your grace abounds in deepest waters. Your sovereign hand will be my guide. When sleep and fear surround me, you never fail, and you won't start now. And I will call upon your name, and keep my eyes above the waves. When the oceans rise, my soul will rest in your name.
Lord, haste to take away the My sin Oh, the bliss of this wondrous thought. My sin not in part, but in whole, is nailed to the cross. I bear it no more. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. Do you need the forgiveness of God's heart? Then his invitation at this very moment needs to be answered by you as we stand together and as we sing.
Can he still feel the nails every time I fail? Can he hear the crowd cry, crucified?
My heart.